Hello and welcome to Caravanning with the Missus. Thank you very much for tuning in today. Very nice to see you all. If there's some of you out there that haven't subscribed yet and you're thinking about it, would really appreciate it if you didn't mind just getting over and done with and hitting that subscribe button. Thank you very much. Anyway, so today we're going to do date night in the drive as we're nearing the end, very near the end of, well, I wouldn't say the end, you know, where they're relaxing some of the lockdown rules in lockdown number three, because it's actually the Saturday the 10th of April. So I'm going to start work next Tuesday, so that'll be nice. My driving instructing, so that'll be good. Anyway, so this will probably be, so this will be, yeah, our last date night during this lockdown, which will be great. So what we're going to do tonight is we're going to have a nice carbonara, vegan, obviously. Yep, and some fun and frolics in the caravan. So I hope you enjoy it. Joining me in the house tonight, I have Eric. And the missus.
Hello.
You hungry, my chick?
Yes, I am.
Awesome.
Looking
I better get
forward to it.
I better get cracking then, hadn't I?
Yes.
All
yeah,
right,
I don't
then.
Mind.
A nice sunny day out as well. Who have we got in the background? Tam Tough by Toots and the Maytals. Happy days. Right, let's get cracking. So, for tonight's meal, carbonara, vegan style, we've chopped up some mushrooms. This is for two of us. I've chopped up probably about 150 grams worth of mushrooms. Just seeing how much is left. 150 grams worth of mushrooms. We're going to have garlic bread with it, Kev's special garlic bread. If you haven't seen that in a previous vlog, then I'll show you again in this one. Kev's special garlic bread, you cut the bread out before you put it in the oven. Very, very important. But we'll carry on with that in a bit. And we're also going to have the vegan plant bacon. But obviously, if you're not vegan, then you can have your only bacon or whatever you want. So yeah, where did we get this from actually, love?
Oh, Sainsbury's.
Sainsbury's, we've got this stuff from. Interesting, I haven't had this before. So we're gonna have half of this, half of that pack, which will be, how many grams? 175 grams, so half of it will be 50, 60, 70, about 75, 80, 90, about roughly 80 grams or so. Anyway, and this is the sauce. We're gonna have plant pioneers no cheese sauce. Where'd you get this from, love?
That's the Sainsbury's brand.
Yeah. Oh, interesting.
We have had it before. It's really nice.
Yeah, so we'll just heat that up. So fairly simple, isn't it? Just need to lightly fry the mushrooms, slightly fry the old bacon bits while those are in the oven. And I've got the kettle on now to boil up for the pasta, which we need. That'll be this in here, won't it? Tagliatelle.
Yeah.
Also in Sainsbury's. Harbour shops are available.
I'm not sure how much you should use though, chicken.
Well, half, probably half.
Really? Half no, not half. Yeah. I don't think so. It's massive.
What's a couple of halves between friends? Oh, there's the old kettle. Right, let's just turn that off. Let's get. So, we now need to get frying.
Well, we'd like some sauce with it, wouldn't we?
We'd like some sauce. Yes. So, we need to, but first of all, we need to start frying, don't we? Because these will only take about 10 minutes to boil, so I think going frying would probably be a good thing to do first. So, where's the old frying pan? Oh, where is the frying pan? Yes, my little fruitette. Oh, right,
on
okay
the
then.
Side.
So, mushrooms are nicely frying. Dry frying, of course, if you can, because there's no point in adding.
Have you got the oven on ready for the
bread? Oh, no, I haven't got the oven.
Yeah, get
yet.
The oven on.
Okay, hang on, I'm just going to add these first. So, add about half a pack of these. A pack being, as I think I said earlier,
you're adding half.
Adding half a pack, so half of 175 grams, whatever that is. You could ask your phone, couldn't you? Anyway, so that's that. I'll pop these back in the old fridge-a-rooney. Who we got on the mo? Oh, we got magic radio now in the background. So let's whack them on a bit. So just lightly frying, and so just to get them nice and translucent. Meanwhile, the water's boiled. Let's move the wine out of the way, because obviously I'm on the red wine. Let's pour the water in there. I've opened a couple of vents again, as usual. Try and get the steam out. There you go. I'm using me Masterclass pot, which I've done a review on in one of my other vlogs, if you want to have a look at the channel, if you're interested. Masterclass being that little chappy there. And we need the oven on now, don't we? Because we need the Kev's special garlic bread to go in. Yeah, let's just make sure there's nothing in the way. No, there we go. Lovely. Oh, hang on, there's the old pop him down there. Yeah, lovely. Lovely, lovely. Mmm, that does actually smell quite bacony.
Does it?
Yeah. Because Sadie's never had meat or bacon,
no,
have you?
I can't smell it from here.
No, you can't smell stuff very well either.
No.
No, that does. That's got a good bacony tang. The, who is it? John and Mandy on Tour channel.
Yes.
They liked this. They did a review of various vegan alternatives to meaty things. And they liked this, didn't they?
Yeah, they did.
So do I need to add the garlic to that now while it's frying? A bit of garlic to it?
I think it says, you've got this, yeah, you could do, I suppose. And then so the add, sauce.
Now, we love our garlic, so I'll just put a generous amount of garlic on.
Maybe Jobs some, have you got some black pepper?
Yep, we got some black pepper. Add a splodge of this. And then what do we do? It's pretty much the sauce then, isn't it? Let it cool down and add a bit of salt, add the sauce, and then just let it simmer for a bit.
Yeah, just on a low heat.
So, pretty simple, pretty straightforward. We'll just add the... pop the bread in the oven. Do you say oven or do you say oven, love?
Oven.
So do I. Interesting. Or is it interesting? Perhaps it's not interesting at all. So there we go. Let's pop that up to the oven. Oven up to six. I'm now going to put the frying pan down to a minimal heat.
Yeah.
So what I usually do is add a bit of water to the pot just to flush it out and then add it in.
Yeah,
so it's going to be doing a bit of simmering for a bit. Yeah, just a drop. So let's just add a plant pioneers no cheese sauce. What's actually in it then?
I don't know.
It's cauliflower and a coconut oil and soya-based alternative to cheese sauce. Seasoned with fennel, garlic and white pepper. Oh, hang on. Yeah, pastas. There you go. Hang on. Oh, no, I haven't got the top vent open. Let's open him. Let some of that steam out. There you go. Ooh, that was close. Okay, so we'll add the old sauce. And just a drop of water in there. This is what I do. Drop of water in the pot. Give it a good old shake. And then take the lid off just to get the, just to try and empty the pot out. Sorted, happy days. Put that in there because that's going to be recycled. WeBuyAnyCar.com. So, simmering very slightly. That's boiling. Yes, it is Saturday night. It's a fancy dance. Sounds like a bit of Bob Marley. We're jamming. How does Bob like his donuts?
Jamming.
We're jamming.
Oh God.
Classic. The old ones are the best. Right, so it's all coming to a bit of a head. So I just have to have a little swig. Right, so
yeah,
I've turned the oven off now because the that dinner seems to do things quite quickly,
yes,
doesn't it?
It does,
so the bread's done, getting nice and brown, which is great. So what I need to do now is we need to empty the water out of the old pasta using the old whatever it is saucepan. I don't use a colander, quite simply because I haven't got one. So I'm just, after draining the water out, I just heat it on the pan for a bit to get rid of the excess. Just turn it up a bit. Live audience. So in 2 days' time, hang on, what's the date now? Yeah, so it's the 10th, 11th, 12th. Restrictions relaxed. To a point, not completely, obviously. That's quite exciting, really, because I haven't worked this year, basically, as a driving instructor. Last time I worked was New Year's Eve, I think, something around there. And we've been locked down ever since. Wow. People seem quite optimistic that this year is going to be a bit different to the last year. I hope that is the case. But
we never know, do we?
No. Tagliatelle, just get it nice and al dente. And then, hang on a minute, I'm turning this off because you wanted something, didn't you? So pop that in the old sauce, like so. Oh, you wanted cutlery, that was it.
You need to turn the heat off because it's evaporating.
Yep. And then, right, okay, so let's get the garlic bread out. For those of you that haven't seen my Kev special garlic bread video that I did earlier in the year, then you can get it all again for free. So what we got? Bum, bum, bum. So with my garlic bread, this is what I like to do. I like to cut the, this is actually sourdough bread, isn't it? Which we got from Aldi, which we quite like. So by cutting it in half means it's nice and crispy on the top as well as the underneath. And then let's just pop the frying pan up there. Then, where's the margarine? It's in here. So, what I like to do is, where was the garlic? Oh, here it is.
Yeah.
So what I like to do is, look, just adjust the camera.
No.
The most remarkable devoted service to.
So what I like to do is just sprinkle a generous amount of the garlic powder on the bread, because we love our garlic. It's important you do this after it's been cooking, because I find it loses, the garlic loses a lot of flavour in the oven. Right, so I put a generous amount of the garlic granules on the bread. Now a generous amount of marge, and that's basically the Kev special garlic bread. The important thing is doing all this after it's been in the oven, because the flavour kind of goes. Eric, I think, Eric's bedding down, I think, bless him. It's a funny old thing he likes to do every night. We get his bed all nice and comfy, don't we? Or how we think it's going to be comfy. He spends the next half an hour sorting it all out, pushing things around, and ends up sleeping on the floor because he's pushed it all out on his bed. There we go. Apparently that's something he's inherited from his wolf ancestors. So I was watching on telly the other day. Right, okay. So, here we go. Vegan carbonara. All right. Do you want more pasta or more carbonara? You probably want.
Thank you.
you go.
Thanks. Yeah, that's enough for now. Thank you.
That's
enough.
Vegan carbonara. What does it taste like to you who's never tasted meat?
It's really flavoursome.
In what way? The flavours are fulsome.
It's really nice. Smoky, mushroomy, creamy.
Let's get my wine. Let's have a go. Because I've not had these bacon bits before. No, I would say that is very smoky. It's lovely, isn't it?
Nice, isn't it?
Now, I have obviously tasted bacon 20 years ago. I would say it is a similar sort of thing, I would say.
How is it?
Smokiness and saltiness. Yeah. Banging.
Yeah.
Banging. It's really nice.
Yeah, mine tastes like it's really satisfying.
It is,
yeah.
It's gorgeous. Yeah. Oh, here we go.